No. Hey YouTube, it's your boy LRF, and today I'm going to show you how to build a Dolby Atmos home theater setup for around $1,000. Yes, it's still a lot for some folks, but you know, it's still ways to reduce the price, which I'll show you a little bit. And we're going to do this thing. Let's go. And I'm going to start here on crutchfield.com. And why I'm using this site is because it's easy to navigate and to break down the different things that you might be looking into for a receiver. That's why I'm using this site. Most of the sites are very complicated just to search for an item or whatnot. They won't make it as simple as Crutchfield do. So we're going to start here. As you see, this is a Denon 13 AVRX 1300. I had one of those a few years back, and it was a good receiver, but it was lacking in wattage. But let's keep going. And you see, that's the Onkyo. I'm not really caring about that, but this is the Denon right there. That's the current model, the 1400. Another Onkyo RZ. 510. No, I'm not too keen about Onkyo, even though I have one in my living room, you know. All right, this is looking promising right here. The Denon AVR 2300, $449.99, $450. All right, the wattage 95, price is promising. They also have open box, which you could take advantage of if you don't care too much about that. More than likely, still get warranty with it. Let's just start with $449.99. Here we go. Alright. And that's that. Okay. Now let's look at some speakers. I was already searching around a little bit and I found this 5.1 system by Pioneer. It's a few years old, but it hung in there for quite a bit of time. It's a very nice setup. It got top ratings on Amazon. Pretty much any site you find them on, they have good ratings. At one time, I even considered purchasing myself, but then I changed my mind and went higher up to the clip setup that you see in my other videos. All right, here's a few more pictures. All right. I think these speakers are about 100 watts. Channel or something like that. Anyway, let's add that. That's 550. Oh, sorry about the cutoff screen right there. I'm having a hell of a time using this program to copy my computer screen. Let's keep on going. All right, let's get some HDMI cables. I like the Amazon Basics HDMI cords. They're just what you need. They're high speed to be used with 4K and stuff like that, and the price is great and the quality is phenomenal. I've seen much more expensive cords that do not compare in quality, so this is great. So I'm gonna get three of these. You could get any amount you need. I just pretty much think one for the television, one for the receiver to the player, you know, stuff like that. You know, extra one just for something I didn't oversee. I didn't foresee. So that brings it to $1,010. All right. Now for a subwoofer cable, I like Media Bridge. The decent quality RCA cable. You get a decent length for the price. Not saying they're not better quality, but for the money, this is pretty good. And I doubt if you'll go past 15 feet with a subwoofer. So this is great. $10, so that's 120, 1,020. Keep going. And some speaker wire. I love 12 gauge. This is from Monoprice, but it's been sold on Amazon. $40 for 100 feet. You might not need that much, but I like to buy extra just in case. So especially if I have a few long runs, so I have plenty to cover that. So that's $40. So that's saw 1060. All right. Let's do some comparison shopping. Let's see if I could get these speakers a little cheaper. As you see here, here's the subwoofer, $130. All right, on sale. And then let's see if we can find any more. All right, there's the bookshelf speakers. That's $100. $230. Plus 80, that's 310, and then 200 more, that's 510. So we saved a few dollars right there. You know, this is how I search around and find comparable prices and try to get it cheaper. All right, you could do the same thing with the receiver. See, the Denon AVR 2300. All right, we're gonna copy and we're gonna paste it in eBay, see if you can beat that price. And let's see what pops up. All right, so 385. Let's make it lowest to highest. Okay, 385. Yeah. See, good. You know, get it cheaper, under $400, brand new, open box, whatever you may be looking for. Save a few dollars like that. I'm sure, especially now this holiday season, you probably could find even more comparable prices or bring down your price even more. Also use shopping tools that, you know, like if I select an item on a page and looking at it, it'll also bring me comparable price, see if you can beat the price that I'm looking at right then. It's very important when you're shopping online to have apps like that onto your computer. It helps you a lot and save you a lot of money at times. Okay, I'll hit click this. So I definitely think I'm gonna go with the 2300. See, 1059, and I probably save another few bucks there. So I'm probably under $1,000 now, back under $1,000. But I'm forgetting one thing, the most important thing to make this a Dolby Atmos system. I forgot to get the Dolby Atmos speakers. So let's go and look for that. There we go. See what comes up. $100 for Onkyo. And here we go. We just found the Pioneer Dolby Atmos speakers. That's real good. $100 on sale, half price. That's a real savings there. $11.59 total. And remember, if you could search around a little bit, you probably could save more money, you know, and be around, seriously, around $1,000. I'm not exactly trying to get to $1,000, but on this video, but you see what I'm talking about by showing you different options or whatnot, how you could reduce how much it costs you. See, Jet. See, this is what I'm talking about, using a shopping tool to see if you can beat your prices. See, compare it to what Jet has. eBay, $165. So this is absolutely the best price that's up on the web right now. So I'm gonna go with that. Well, I hope this helped you some. to help build your Adobe Atmos setup, especially if you just want an entry level setup. This is really a beginner's guide to help you out with that, and I hope you enjoyed. Thank you for joining me. Remember to thumbs up, comment, and subscribe. I'm always looking for new subscribers to grow this channel and grow together. So I appreciate you all for joining me. Y'all take it easy.